Edition. I'm Brad Pomerance in Long Beach today, joined by the supervisor representing this area and much more. Her name is Janice Hahn, and she is a supervisor for Los Angeles County. She's no longer a member of Congress. A voluntary move on your part. Let's talk about your new job. What made you decide to come back home, run, and win for the job of supervisor?
I think anybody that understands the governance of Los Angeles County would understand why I jumped at the chance to leave Congress, which when I served there and still is a very polarizing, partisan, sometimes gridlocked governmental body. So to have the chance to be one of five members of the Los Angeles County Board of Supervisors, governing 10 million people, having a budget of about $30 billion, I think people understand why. Not to mention, you know, my dad served on the board for 40 years, and the building that we meet in is named
He's legendary. The family is legendary. But it is worth noting that, as you said, while being a member of Congress, even in a polarizing time, is an honor and you can do great work, you're one of five in a county of 10 million. And on a day in and day out basis, the work of the county impacts us dramatically, probably more than a member of Congress or even a city councilman, state senator, state assemblyman.
Yeah, the responsibilities of the County of Los Angeles to really provide so many services for everyday people is enormous. And probably from the time you wake up to the time you go to bed, from the time you're born till the time you die, the County of Los Angeles has something to say about your quality of life.
I want to talk about a challenge the county is facing. And that's the challenge surrounding homelessness. And I have to say, when the homelessness came out for 2017, the press releases, the press conferences, I could tell how truly devastated you all were to see that homelessness had spiked 23%, that there are now close to 60,000 homeless in our county, especially given that the voters have been so generous. In November, the city voters were generous. November was the city, and March was the county,
correct.
and still we're still facing this crisis.
Well, I think we would be in a much worse shape if the voters of the city of Los Angeles and then the voters of LA County had not been so visionary and generous in their willingness to tax themselves to address the problem. So that money actually hasn't been spent
yet. Of course, and that's fair and important to mention.
Yes, so we would be in much worse shape. But to think that there is 57,000 people on any given night that are sleeping on the streets of LA County is devastating to me. It's shocking to me. The numbers were staggering, is what I said.
Although,
it's unbelievable.
I do want to ask about Long Beach, because I see the smile on your face, because Long Beach was one of the bright spots.
Yes.
You know, it's hard to know with counting, but it does appear that homelessness has dipped pretty significantly in Long Beach. What's going on
well,
here?
Long Beach is doing a lot of things right, and Long Beach can serve as a model for the rest of the county in how we address the problem. They've been ahead of the game in terms of aged out foster kids. They've worked, they have mental health services here in Long Beach and are increasing the access that people have. Their city council is very forward thinking in terms of shelters and creating year-round shelters as opposed to just winter shelters. So they've done a lot of things right, but you know, still, I'm sure they would say we haven't ended homelessness in Long Beach.
I want to ask about those two measures of the past, HHH and H. One focuses on creating permanent supportive housing. The other one focuses on maybe staffing up that permanent supportive housing. You have the city of LA, at least, and the county working together. I guess the fear for some is, how quickly can this money get spent? For example, I hearken to a state measure, Prop 1, the water bond, passed in 2014. it's not 2017. We haven't seen a lot of spending. And so this is a real crisis with homelessness. How quickly can we get moving on this?
Well, again, the county of LA did this right before I got there.
Okay, fair.
The county put together a 47-point plan on how to address homelessness. Everything from, you know, rent subsidies to aged-out foster kids to mental health services to job training to preventing people from becoming homeless. So we're ready with a plan. We're ready to spend this money. We don't start actually collecting the tax dollars until October.
That's true.
But because we are so focused on solving this problem, we're going to begin spending the money in July. So we're ready. We're going to hit the ground running. We're going to begin spending this money. I think the more difficult challenge will be the building of the affordable housing that we really need to increase to have places for people to live.
So this is separate from permanent supportive housing. This is an affordable housing question. And that brings up a very valid point, because we are facing an affordable housing crisis. And I'd like to break that up into two: affordable housing as a term of art and housing that is affordable. I mean, those are two individual crises that are fueling our homeless crisis. I mean, H and HHH really didn't address those two challenges. Should we at a city level, county level? Is it more of a state question?
You know, and I think the number, the increase in the amount of homeless forces us to look at why more people are becoming homeless. Mm-hmm. Because at this point, we're not even treading water. We're not staying the same. We're drowning. So we're having more people become homeless. And we think it's because rents are rising. Mm-hmm. We think because people can't afford to either find some place or stay in the place where they are currently. So we have to look at overall the rents in LA County and how we can prevent current people who are in units from being kicked out on the street because their rents become so high. But so yeah, that's an issue we have to look at.
But what can the county do as a government? Because, you know, there are rent control measures in cities and the state gets involved, it gets complicated. You know, the market continues to be hot. You know, God bless the economic recovery.
Well, it's hot because we don't have enough units. You know,
well,
the demand is higher than the supply. That's why I'm sure rents are higher. We need to build more. We need to catch up with the number of units that we should be building in LA County to even satisfy the current need.
I understand.
Not even talking about those who have been on the streets.
So is there places to build, infill, or taking old units and revamping them, making a mixed use? I mean,
well, that's what we need to begin looking. What I've asked for from our county real estate section.
Got it.
Let's look at county owned land right now. Mm-hmm. I want a list of where county property is that we might look at to build.
Empty
or low level that we can maybe build on top of for some nice units that people can afford to live in. And I think if the county doesn't put our money where our mouth is, we can't expect other cities and municipalities to also begin looking for places to build affordable housing. Our biggest challenge is going to be people, understandably, who don't want you know, more density in their communities and neighborhoods, and to take care of these people.
It's part of the education
process. But I do think the fact that county residents agreed to tax themselves, you know, that doesn't happen in the rest of the country. Most people complain about taxes. This was a vote of confidence, I think, in LA County and our ability to address this problem.
So her name is Janice Hahn. She is a member of the Board of Supervisors in LA County. I'm Brad Pomerance, Local Edition.